The second depth to weld case that I'm going to teach you is where the stickers of the corner and edge on the top layer are the same. So before I show you how to solve cases where we have the same color sticker on top, I need to show you what another of our corner insertion algorithms is doing. So you might remember from the beginner tutorial that if you had a white corner piece with its sticker facing towards us, you would do a U, then R, then U prime, R prime. Doing that a bit more slowly, we can see exactly what this is doing. So the U moves this corner piece over to this position, the R brings this edge piece up into the middle layer, the U prime matches up these, and the R prime brings it back down. Similar to the first case, we now see that doing those four moves, doing that algorithm, brings not only this corner piece down into the bottom layer, but also brings the edge piece that's situated here into the middle layer. So if you follow this edge piece while I do that algorithm, you'll see how that works. So the U moves them both over to here, the R brings the edge piece here up, U prime brings these two pieces on top, and R prime puts them back down like that. So that's exactly what this algorithm is doing. And if we get a case where the corner and edge stickers on top are the same, we need to set it up to this case. Again, like with the first F2L case, we need to know how to mirror this algorithm on the left-hand side. So if you have, for example, a case where we have this F2L pair paired up already, but it needs to go into this slot here on the left, what we can do is instead of doing our algorithm on the right, if the white sticker is facing towards us and we have the F2L pair paired up, we can just go like this. Move it across, doing a U prime. L prime brings up this slot here, U to put it there, and then L to bring them both back down. So let me do that again. So U prime brings this pair over here. L prime brings open the empty slot. U moves it there, and then L moves it back down. And to solve F2L cases where you have two of the same color sticker on the top face, you'll need to know how to insert the pair on the left and the right, as I've just shown you. So let's start out with an easy case. We'll choose to solve this white, orange, and blue corner piece, and the orange and blue edge piece is over here. So we see that the stickers on facing the top side are the same. Now, as you will have seen doing the algorithms beforehand, if we do a U, R, U prime, R prime, that inserts this corner down to here, and also inserts this edge into the middle layer. So our problem here is that we need to move this edge over to this position without moving this corner. So we need to figure out a way to move this over here. And similarly to the first F2L case, again, we can hide the corner in the bottom layer. Now, we can hide it in two ways. Firstly, we can hide it with an F move, like that, into the bottom layer, or we can hide it with an R prime move, like that, into the bottom layer, from this position. And when we have the case where there are two stickers on top which are the same, only one of those will be useful to us. So if we hide it with an R prime, like that, and we try to bring this edge over to this position, like that, and we undo that and unhide the corner by doing an R, this edge will go to the back there, like that. So that won't be useful at all. So if we undo that, we have to hide it with an F, basically. So what that does, we move the corner to the bottom layer there. Now we can bring this corner over to here. And when we move this corner piece back up by doing an F prime, the edge piece there won't be affected. So we do an F to bring this corner down, this orange sticker down here. Move this edge piece over here by doing a U2, like that. So the orange sticker goes here. And then we do an F prime, and that matches up this corner and this edge piece like that. And then we have the simple right insertion. So we move across here, bring up the slot, move it across the other way, and then bring the slot back down. So the way that I like to think about it is the side that you'll use to hide the corner piece is the side with the white sticker of the corner piece on it. So for example, here, the white sticker piece is here. So we're going to rotate this side to hide the corner piece. because if we rotate this side, we'll get the problem where if we put this over here, it will go to the back. So we'll use this side where the white sticker is to hide the corner piece. And if we move it that way, that doesn't hide it. So remember, hide it by putting it into the bottom layer using one move. So hide it like that, bring the edge across, unhide it, and then you have the simple insertion. So let's do another example where we choose to solve this slot. So the corner piece that belongs over here is down here, the white, orange, and blue corner piece, and the corresponding edge piece is up here. So after we recognize which pieces to solve, the second step is to move them both into the top layer. So here the edge is already in the top layer, but we need to move this corner up into the top layer as well. So we can do that by just moving it up, across, and down, like so. Now we have the case where the stickers of the corner and edge piece that we want to solve are the same, facing upwards. And also, with the corner here on the left side, facing towards us, we have the left insertion case, which goes like this. U prime, L prime, U, L, like that. And if you remember what I showed you before, that insertion sequence of moves moves this corner down to this position, as well as this edge here to this position. So what we need to do is move this edge to here without moving this corner, as that will pair this edge and corner up and we can simply insert it. So we hide this corner into the bottom layer using the side with the white sticker of the corner on it. So using this side, because the white sticker is here, we can hide it like that. Now this edge piece needs to go here so that when we bring this blue sticker up here, they'll be paired up. So move the edge piece over there like that, and then unhide the corner piece. And now our F2L pair is already paired up. So then what we need to do is move it into this slot. So like here, bring the slot up, you bring the slot down. And now we've solved this F2L pair. So here is the exact same case, but we now have an extra restriction. So we've got the exact same case where the corner is here and the edge is back here. However, we see that this slot is solved. So if we do an F prime to hide our corner like that, this slot comes out into the top layer, and anything that we do to move the top layer around will mess up these two pieces that we've already solved. So we can't hide the corner like that. And also, we can't hide the corner like this because we need to bring this edge here to pair it up, and if we move the corner back, this edge piece will be out of the top layer. So we need to figure out how to pair up these two pieces without messing up what we've already solved. And the way we can do this is move this corner piece over to there. Now, when we hide it into the bottom layer, what we're bringing up is actually the slot where it belongs. So this slot is already empty. So we can move this corner piece over here, and using the face with the white sticker on it, hide it. There's nothing in this slot, so it doesn't matter. So we can use it to hide the corner piece. Now if you bring this edge piece over to here, like that, when we unhide it, unhide this corner piece, these two pieces will be paired up. And now that we've paired this up, they belong in this left slot here. So we do our simple moves to put it into the left, like that. So the next case, the third and final case, is where we have a white sticker, not facing the side, but where we have the white sticker of the corner on top. And I'm going to show you how to solve that case in the next video.